I'm sorry I had to speak in Hindi language because the majority of the people no understand Hindi. In the Western civilization, suddenly I find people have taken to a very licentious, vulgar, despicable life. I can't believe how can they be so stupid and idiotic. It seems they have no wisdom even to see that this is stupidity. Thank God you have achieved this self-realization. You got the light. You are so transformed. You look so beautiful. And that you have given up all those funny ideas of freedom. It's so clear-cut. This must be, I don't know what to say, that in those Western countries to find out people who have such wise understanding of pure love and respect for your own purity. As if suddenly you have come out of that darkness and have bathed in the light of the Divine. It's not possible otherwise. See the history of the Western countries, they never had very great kings, you know. One king in England killed 7 wives, you know. If you, in India, if one wife was killed, he would have been killed first of all, before he killed the second one. So one sees that despite all that kind of a history and that kind of a vulgarity that has been going on for days together, and now it is the worst after war, suddenly you people have come up like lotuses and have made those countries so fragrant and so beautiful. But now they are afraid because they believe in licentiousness, they believe in vulgarity, they think it is their freedom. So they do attack you, but you are not to be bothered because you have achieved something that is real, that is for eternal life. They are supposed to be Christians, Jews, and also Muslims there. Among all of them, I am surprised to see how they have interpreted these 3 great religions in the most contradictory way. For Christ has said that if you make any sin with your eyes, commit some sins, then remove your eyes yourself. If one hand does anything wrong, you cut that hand. I have never seen anybody without an eye or without a hand in the whole of these Christian kingdoms. Nowhere. They can cut others, but their own I have never seen. It's very difficult to be a Christian, I tell you. Because this is an impossible situation. For that, we can say that this was for angels, must be for the fallen angels that you take out your eye and cut your hand. And then Muhammad Sahib has said, he thought that why only the men are handled by Christ. So he says, no, not that you cut it, but let others cut your hand and take out your eyes. And for women it is so that they should be buried in the Mother Earth halfway and should be stoned. Think of American women, what would have happened to them? So very difficult to follow Islam, also impossible. They were very great people, very pure, and they thought that this is the only way people can be kept pure. No. On the contrary, with all these things, compulsion, they become extremely immoral. This suppression doesn't help. And then also this, they call it one that is Islamic laws, Sharia, was actually given by Moses to Jews. You can find it out in the Bible. It was given by Moses to Jews, and the Jews would not accept it. They were sensible to say, we can't accept this, much too much. So that was taken over by Muhammad Sahib, better put it for these people. But with all these doing, people become extremely immoral, extremely quarrelsome, and go to the other side, and such an imbalance is created. But after self-realization, the Sahaj culture is born within you. With this Sahaj culture, you come into balance. And people are surprised at the Western Sahaj yogis, that, mother, how have you made their eyes so pure? How can they get rid of these bad habits of looking at every woman or every man? What have you done to their eyes? How have they become so pure? It is the light of your own spirit which is shining through your eyes. It's very important. Again, I would say that the women in the West have to understand what is Sahaj Yoga, not dominating anyone. Here the women are dominated, not always, but to great extent. And there what you find that women are dominating. Firstly, they believe in divorce, and they try to harass people with that. This domination, maybe we can say, comes from their upbringing. But Sahaj Yoga should change completely your ideas, and there should be no domination, but a complete understanding, about which I have told you many a times and explained to you. Still, I must say, I am overwhelmed by the response. And on behalf of the Divine Power, I would like to thank you very much. It's really a new race that has come up, really. Somewhere somebody goes wrong or something happens, doesn't matter. But on the whole, it's such a beautiful race of people. I face them before me. Even in dreams, people could not have believed it. They don't yet believe. But it has happened. You must now have an enlightened faith, which we call as Shraddha. With that enlightened faith, I am sure you will adhere to the emancipation of human beings. It's your duty now. It is all given free. Of course, Sahaj Yoga is free. You can have it free. Don't have to pay anything. All right. But you have to give to others. That is very important. It is free to you, and you cannot keep it to yourself. If you keep it to yourself, you can never be happy, you can never be joyous. So you have to be absolutely collective, and then you will see how it works out. Very surprising, in all the European countries, in America, South America, Australia, Japan, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Kuala Lumpur, everywhere I have seen people have become collective. And they told me, Mother, there's no greater joy than seeing people getting self-realization. That is the greatest joy one has. And this is what one has to have in your mind. Of course, there are some people who start criticizing Sahaj Yoga, why this, why that, all nonsense. But actually, if you see, everybody who is a deep Sahaj Yogi wants that Sahaj Yoga should spread in their own countries. And then to see that it is accepted all over the world. It is such a wisdom which has come into their mind. Otherwise, one fellow told me, Mother, I was only worried about my own house, my family, motor car and this and that. Now I've forgotten all that. Now I'm only worried, how will I be able to give this joy to others? I cannot be happy alone. And that's what it has happened. And I'm very thankful to you, for all of you who have come here all the way to celebrate my birthday. And this is just your love and affection for me. And I also love you very much. May God bless you. Today's puja is going to be a bit short. I don't know what in my birthday, which deity's puja you are doing. So there are all deities, all of them are there. So it has to be short, with all of them being worshipped together. It works out much faster, I think. As when you, all of you are together, things work out much faster.